So here we go again for a new live building. Let me know if the sound is good, if you can hear me. And, I don't really know what I will do today. Probably some kind of landscape. Hey, Game Jam Creator, how are you? So, yeah, some kind of landscape, I think. So I start from scratch using Bonzomatic. And as usual, I start by deleting everything I don't like. And yeah, I don't have really a precise idea of what I will do. I will just try something, maybe around translucency like last time. So as always, I start by making the sphere function, sphere distance field function, and the mag function containing my scene. Right now it's just a sphere of radius 0.5. I will need normal. So let's make the normal function. The start is always a bit long, a few minutes, just putting the basic things. But it's a nice warm up when you need to do that in a short amount of time. So my starting point and my vector, my view vector. And my current position. We also have a current distance. And now the remeshing loop. So this is the condition to know if we hit something. And this is the condition if we have we are too far from the start and we want to stop. It's mostly there to gain a bit of performance when a ray go directly to the sky. Okay. And now when we have a collision, we get the normal and we will put a light like here. And here we get the color out. Okay, we have a basic sphere. That's great. Now what I want is more like a landscape. So the floor. It will be something like that. And we have a landscape. Maybe the music's a bit too loud, lower it a bit. Okay. I don't really like let's add a specular, so al vector like that. Hi Valden, how are you? Let's make a target function. Hi Havoc, how are you? Well, so now there is a target function I need to do, so the z direction is just the target minus the start, then the x direction is a cross product that I can normalize, just to be sure, of something like that. And cy is just a cross product of the first two. And now I can change this. Okay, it's just can invert, UV, and I have the same, but now I can change the target position individually. Let's divide all of this by the distance. Maybe even square distance and add some gamma correction. So that's nothing really that great. Now maybe we can add something to the floor using a texture. Now, I think I will add the box. Hyperborgian. Now let's add the box. Is it broken? Oh yes. So something like that, and now we will, I think we will repeat it. So the repetition is something like that. So we will have size. Maybe we will all, yeah. And now if I use RP there, I should have lots of little boxes. I don't know if you can see everything. Hi Alkama. I will make it more clearer. Hey, yeah, I have a can. So now what I want to do, to use several cubes, like I don't know how many, 5, so I can repeat them at different interval. Something like that, and now I can simply subtract off, and now okay, of course it should be only, yeah. Size should also be not let's observe rotate it. Something like that. Okay. Let's rotate the camera a little bit. Oh, I don't have the time. Hi Coltus, who are you? What am I doing wrong there? Probably, yeah. Now what I want is to make all those cubes translucent. Should be possible. Yeah. So I will use the same trick I showed last time. So just using a side value. Not breaking. Yeah. So when you have a collision, you just invert side and you use, you lower the opacity like that and you offset a little bit. And there we have. So I think we should lower the... Yeah. Maybe a Fresnel would be great. If you have any question, don't let me know. So my Fresnel is just using the normal, the dot product with the normal and the ray direction. You take the 1 minus and you can leave it to the power. And so maybe what I would like is the floor to be not translucent. So I will here change the material to be 1 or 0 depending of the which is the nearest to the camera, the floor or the box. So I should be able here to take the mat. I always copy it there because I don't want to be it to be changed in the normal function, which calls the same mat function. And so now I should be able to hear if I should be able to exit early. I think it's working if I don't put it. I'm not sure. Let's change the color simply. So we can see if what we do change something. Okay. So matte is in fact translucent bit. You can see what's happening there. Okay, there it's working. It's the inverse of what I want, but yeah. Spec, we call that base, like the base color. We'll have a spec. It will be something like that. So I can use it there. Something a little bit. Maybe it's too bright. You can just lower that. But what I want is only to have boxes on the ground. And I don't really know how to do that yet. Let's put a smooth mean function.
Je suis désolé, et je ne peux pas être empereur. Ce n'est pas mon affaire. Je connais conquérir ni diriger personne. Je voudrais aider tout le monde dans la mesure du possible. Juifs, chrétiens, païens, blancs et noirs. Nous voudrions tous nous aider si nous pouvions. Les êtres humains sont pacifiques. Nous voulons donner le bonheur à notre prochain à lui donner le malheur. Nous ne voulons pas haïr ni humilier personne, personne.
Ok. So now I want to make the boxes disappear when they are too high. So something like that. I don't know what way. Yeah, I want to subtract it. So. Now I will make something smooth, very large smooth. And now I only have the boxes near the ground. Now I will make them dancer. Yeah, this song is a bit weird. And now I want them to only appear sometime, maybe using cylinder. So I will repeat the cylinder. I will also repeat them, something like that. Okay, now I have added them, but I want to subtract them, in fact, so, yeah. And boxes could be maybe bigger. Oh, that's strange. Oh yes, here I am. The floor is not wandering under the crystal thingy. So to do that better, I should simply cut the crystal by, yeah, like that. You see, you just cut. What is Bunei? So yeah, I can. There, I can cut it by the ground. So I just cut it with a slight offset. And now you can see the floor under. Yeah. Maybe I need a sky color. So what I like to do for the sky. Just to take just the Y position now. The Fresnel value. Let's try something very radical. Oh yeah, not that great. Now what I want is some kind of fog, and that's what's missing here. I'll make a function fog. It's the position of the distance. Maybe. Radius, I don't know, so ray direction. Maybe make color. And the same I put there. I also need to put it at the end if something has not been. Something like that. Yeah, there's some issue. Now what I... Now I would like each of the crystal to have a different color, maybe. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, and now for the color, how will I do that? Maybe just something like that. So it's here, I can do that. Use the flow that, and I only want one direction. Let's try that. With something like that. Now I will rotate the color. I like to do rotate color. Let's often do quite cool color. Is that working? Not really. Let's just move. No, I can do that. I can do that. Yeah. So my random doesn't work. Yeah. Oh no, yeah, it doesn't work because I must change the... Yeah, I will do something like that maybe, but yeah, probably very costly if I do that. Oh no, yes, what I can do is to have an atmosphere, everything that is inside. We'll just add if we are inside. No, maybe something like that. Doesn't work that well. Don't really know why that is not working. Yes, okay. Okay, I start to have colors. Oh yes, that's because I was not touching. That was always between 1 and 0. Fog is a bit too low. I test things, but it doesn't really work that well. Did I put some refraction? No. Maybe that's something that could change things a bit. Maybe add an auto-occlusion or something. It starts to be a bit slow, maybe. Something going from the inside looks interesting. I Maybe it's a bit too... too close. One nice thing would be to add the color of the crystal around the thing, but I don't really know how to do that. Just try not doing that, but yeah. I don't think my gamma at the end is very good. Yeah, there is so much contrast there. I like that better. Bit too slow, maybe I should. Oh, what I can do is if prod is too low, break. Maybe that can help. Like that. Yeah, it doesn't really help. One run too high. I should stop that. No, it's not. It's a bit faster now. Still not that smooth. It's a bit strange. Maybe it's just that the time is a bit too high. Okay, it works better. I just reset the time every 10 seconds or every 5 seconds. And I put it somewhere else. Okay, what I seen, I guess I seen is it's not really what I had in mind at first, but it kinda works. So let me know if you have any questions. If not, I think I will close the stream. Can recap a little bit what I did. So I'm still using the side thing for translucency. So when we get a collision, we just invert the side and reflect the ray, and we can go as a we continue running the ray. Then I simply do some cube repetition, cylinder, and also the floor. Should have a little bumps. Yeah. Anyway, thank you for coming. I hope the stream was enjoyable. I will put a VOD on YouTube probably tomorrow. Yeah. So, bye!